Good evening, children. Welcome back to the class. As you know, in class 11, we are dealing with chapter 3, that is Plant Kingdom. And this is our sixth lecture today in this chapter. And the topic that we are going to deal today is bryophytes. Now, as you know, that bryophytes are considered as a sort of a land plant. Why? Because this is the first plant which made an attempt to come to land. Though it could not be quite successful, and we still call them to be amphibians, but still it made an attempt to come to the land. So among the list of land plants, we have four of them. Bryophyte, which are non-vascular plant, that means they came on land, but they do not have vascular bundles. That means they do not have true root, stem and leaf. This includes three types, mosses, liverworts and hornworts. Then pteridophytes, these are vascular plants, but they still require water for reproduction. So not 100% true land plant. They include lycophyte, ferns, horsetails, wisp ferns, etc. Gymnosperm, first true land plant, because now it can live on land. It is not dependent on both photosynthesis, for both photosynthesis and reproduction on water. That means they not only develop root, stem, leaf and vascular bundles, but their fertilization is no longer dependent on water. And then angiosperms, which are also called as the flowering plants. Amongst them, the one that we are going to study today, that is your bryophytes. So let us start with bryophyte. And before we teach, I teach you bryophyte in details. इससे पहले मैं आपको bryophyte detail में पढ़ाऊंगी. I want you to revise some of the points which we had done in our second lecture. During the general comparison of different parts, what are the some of the points which we have already dealt with? So let us come for bryophyte. I want you to recall these points. These are the amphibians of the plant kingdom. That means though they have come on land, they still depend on water for reproduction. Second, all of them are multicellular. There is no exception. All bryophytes are multicellular. But the body is thallus-like. It is not differentiated into root, stem and leaf. But a root-like structure called as rhizoid is present, which I will be showing you as well in my today's lecture. This rhizoid, it helps just in anchorage, but it does not help in nutrient absorption. It has stem-like colloid. Yes, there is a stem-like structure, but it does not have vascular bundles, so it is not a true stem. And leaf-like phylloid, there are leafy structures, but these leafy structures, they do not contain veins and veinlets, which is a typical characteristic of any leaf. Besides, in them, the vascular bundle is absent and the life cycle is haplodiplontic. That means the main life, the main phase of the plant is haploid gametophyte, but a diploid sporophyte also exists for some time, right? Besides that, you know that in bryophyte, the Anthridium and Archegonium are multicellular and jacketed. Embryo is formed. The gamete is released in the water, but fertilization is internal and no seed formation takes place in bryophytes. Once we have done these points, now we will go, move into bryophytes to discuss all those points in detail. Pehla, so let us see here. These are the first group of plants to colonize land. I told you these are the first terrestrial plants. It is the first land plant. They occur in damp and shady places. Why? Because they still require water for reproduction. So they still prefer to stay in damp and shady places. Next, the gametophyte is the dominant form. I told you the life cycle is haplodiplontic. That means the gametophyte is the dominant form. No true root, leaf is formed or stem. So the body is called as thallus. It is anchored by rhizoid. Rhizoid is again not true root. It does just helps in anchorage. Vascular bundle is absent. In the absence of root, the thallus absorbs water and minerals directly from the ground or atmosphere. You remember I told you in bryophyte, wo log hawa se nami talte, they take moisture from the atmosphere. Since they do not have root, hence they live only in moist places. They are very small plants. Since they do not have vascular bundles, and they do not have roots, so obviously, and they have come on land, so they are not very tall. You remember I told them they are not very tall. I told you there was a question why there are no trees in bryophytes, because they do not have root and vascular bundle. So the tallest one is just 15 centimeter, more than 15 centimeter in height. ठीक है, sorry, most of them are 15 centimeter height. The tallest one is 60 centimeter, whose name is Dawsonia. So this is the figure of Dawsonia, which is the tallest bryophyte. I just want you to see this diagram and understand the reproduction once again. Though we have already done it once, I want you to understand it for full and final आज आखिरी बार बहुत अच्छे से समझ लो. The main plant, I'm going to describe everything very carefully. So listen carefully. The main plant of the bryophyte is a gametophyte, right? The gametophyte has root-like structure. This is rhizoid. It has stem-like structure called as root-like rhizoid, stem-like phylloid, right? And it has leaf-like structure called as coloid. ये true root नहीं है क्योंकि केवल anchorage करता absorption नहीं. ये true stem नहीं है, इसमें vascular bundle नहीं है. ये true leaf नहीं है क्योंकि इसमें veins and veinlet नहीं है. This entire plant is a gametophyte. So basically, children, you have to remember this very carefully. क्योंकि यही medical में सबसे ज़्यादा आता है बेटा. अब जो ये life cycle से सबसे ज़्यादा question आता है. So you must understand some things. The gametophyte is differentiated. This is the gametophyte. It is haploid in nature. It is differentiated into root-like, stem-like, leaf-like structures. At the tip of the gametophyte, ये tip है ना बेटा? This is the tip. This is the tip. Gametophyte है तो obviously क्या बनाएगा? Gamete. इसीलिए ना gametophyte बोलते हैं. Gametophyte में नाम ही में ही उसका function है. I told you in biology, phyte means plants. Phyte means plant, and that phase of the plant when the plant makes gametes. That phase of the plant when the plant make gamete, that phase is called as gametophyte. Obviously, it is going to form gamete. And you know that the organ, the structure in which the male gamete is formed, that is called as antheridia. And that structure in which the female gamete will be formed, that is called as archegonia. Okay, that is called as archegonia. You already know this. So let us see where they are located. At the tip of the gametophyte is antheridia and archegonia located, but they are so small and microscopic कि आपको दिख नहीं रहा है. लेकिन यहाँ पर आपके male, female जो gametangia है, antheridia, archegonia पाया जाता है. It is showing in large view over here. See here, archegonia is present. So look at this archegonia. And obviously, if it is archegonia, it will form eggs. So they have a single large non-motile female gamete called as egg. I repeat. सिंगल एक ही है, लार्ज है, देखो बड़ा है, ठीक, नॉन मोटाइल, दे डू नॉट हैव फ्लैजेला, दिस इज एग, दैट इज द फीमेल गैमेट. सिमिलरली देखो इसके टिप में पाया जाता है द मेल गैमेटेंजिया, दैट इज एंथ्रीडिया. यू कैन सी द एंथ्रीडिया इज लाइक दिस इलोंगेटेड क्लब शेप, एंड इन दिस एंथ्रीडिया मेनी मेनी मेल गैमेट, दीज मेल गैमेट्स आर कॉल्ड एज एंथ्रोजोइड्स. They are called as antherozoids, right? Or the male gamete is also called as sperm. This is formed within them. You must notice over here, which I really want you to see, that this male antherozoid or male gamete is flagellated. Why? Because the male gamete will be carried to the female, you know, gametangia by virtue of water. ये पानी से male gamete female के अंदर में जाएगा. क्योंकि मेल गैमेट फीमेल के अंदर पानी से जाएगा तो फ्लैजिलेटेड स्ट्रक्चर विल हेल्प इन द मूवमेंट ऑफ द गैमेट. सो दीज आर द मेल गैमेट्स दैट आर बीइंग फॉर्म्ड. नाउ फर्टिलाइजेशन विल टेक प्लेस. सो लेट मी यू नो रब दिस एंड जस्ट शो यू. सी द मेल गैमेट विल एंटर इन टू द ऊगोनिया. सो दो द मेल गैमेट विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड थ्रू वॉटर, द फर्टिलाइजेशन इज इंटरनल, इट इज विद इन द फीमेल का आर्किगोनिया. अगर मेल फीमेल गैमेट दोनों पानी में फर्टिलाइज करते, वी वुड हैव कॉल्ड इट एन एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन. बट सिंस हियर द मेल गैमेट ट्रांसफर्स इनटू द फीमेल गैमेटेंजिया, दैट इज आर्किगोनिया बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ वाटर, ये वाटर से जाता है तो फर्टिलाइजेशन इज इंटरनल. तो ऑब्वियसली अगर फर्टिलाइजेशन इंटरनल है यहां पर, तो यहां फर्टिलाइजेशन के बाद व्हाट विल बी द स्ट्रक्चर दैट विल बी फॉर्म, दिस फर्टिलाइज स्ट्रक्चर विल बी कॉल्ड एज जाइगोट. ठीक, now see this zygote, you know it will divide to form a multicellular sporophyte. So let us see here, यहाँ ओकोनिया के अंदर फर्टिलाइजेशन हुआ एंड द जाइगोट इज फॉर्म, सॉरी इन आर्किगोनिया के अंदर आपका फर्टिलाइजेशन हुआ एंड द जाइगोट इज फॉर्म. This zygote will now say divide. It has just been turned. देखो इसको turn कर दिया, इसको इधर और इसको इधर ले आया. It is the same diagram, but this is located over here. Within this archegonia, this zygote will divide to form a multicellular sporophyte. Just look at this. This is a sporophyte, and this is a multicellular sporophyte. Now this sporophyte is basically divided into three parts. I am going to teach you again. ये जो सबसे नीचे वाला पार्ट है जो गैमेटोफाइट से सटा हुआ है, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज फुट. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज फुट. नाउ दैट पार्ट राइट, जो दिस स्टॉक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज सीटी. एंड दिस टर्मिनल पार्ट विच इज स्वोलन, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज कैप्स्यूल. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज कैप्स्यूल. एंड द एंटायर स्ट्रक्चर कैप्स्यूल and the entire structure which is shown in red in color, this is your sporophyte. This part is your sporophyte. So you must notice one thing here. This part is your gametophyte, and gametophyte ke upar mein banta hai sporophyte. That means the sporophyte, this is your gametophyte beta. This part is sporophyte. That means, see what I am telling you about sporophyte. This is very 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 important. Ye sari cheeze medical mein aati hai. The sporophyte is not free living. It is not free living. That means you can say it is parasitic on the gametophyte. Ye gametophyte ke upar paya jata hai, so it is parasitic. It is non-green. Ye green nahi hai. Aap dekh sakte ho, ye wala hissa green hai. Photosynthesis ye wala hissa karta hai, ye nahi karta. So it is non-green and non-photosynthetic. Photosynthesis bhi nahi karta. That means this part which is called a sporophyte, which is divided into foot, CT and capsule, it is actually, you know, non-green, parasitic, and it is found on top of the gametophyte. Now since it is a sporophyte, it will form spore. So within this capsule is also known as, you know, it is made up of two parts. This is the stalk and this is the sporangia. You can see this. This is the stalk and this is the sporangia. Within this capsule, मियोसिस करके आपका स्पोर्स बनता है, ठीक है? विद इन दिस सी स्पोर्स आर फॉर्म. नाउ यू नो दैट द स्पोरोफाइट इज डिप्लॉयड. व्हाई? इट हैज बीन फॉर्मड आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन. फर्टिलाइजेशन के बाद जो भी स्ट्रक्चर बनेगा वो कैसा होगा? 2N, बिकॉज द गैमेट इज एन एन एन, राइट? सो दिस स्पोरोफाइट विल अंडरगो मियोसिस टू फॉर्म हैप्लॉइड स्पोर्स. दीज स्पोर्स विल फॉल डाउन एंड फर्स्ट दे फॉर्म अ लीफी स्ट्रक्चर, ठीक है? दिस लीफी स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोटोनीमा. इट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोटोनीमा. दिस प्रोटोनीमा फर्दर डिवाइड्स टू फॉर्म दिस इरेक्ट स्ट्रक्चर वंस अगेन, ठीक है? इट विल डिवाइड टू फॉर्म दिस इरेक्ट स्ट्रक्चर एंड वंस अगेन दिस गैमेटोफाइट विल बी फॉर्म विथ फुट, सॉरी विथ राइजोइड, देन कोलॉइड स्टेम लाइक एंड फाइलॉइड. Is that clear? So this is how the life cycle continues. So I will show this once again to you. I have cleared the board. I will show it to you once again. Once this diagram is clear, trust me, you have almost learned bryophyte. There's nothing left to be learned. Now look at this once again. The main plant body of the bryophyte is a gametophyte. It has root like rhizoid, stem like colloid, leaf like phylloid. At the tip of this gametophyte are formed the gametangia. The female gametangia is called as archegonia and the male gametangia is called as anthridia. Okay? Now within the archegonia is found a single large non-motile female egg. Within the anthridia are formed many thousands of flagellated male gamete called as anthrozoid or sperm. These sperms will enter into the oogonia through water. So fertilization takes place through water, but the fertilization is internal. So it is within this archegonia. Archegonia ke andar. So let me show you this. Suppose this archegonia ko main yahan enlarge kar do. To is archegonia ke andar aapka fertilized zygote, yani ke the first cell of the sporophyte bana. Now this will divide and redivide to form a multicellular what? Sporophyte. This sporophyte is divided into foot, CT and capsule. You can see this. It divided and redivided. This branch has been made this side to form. Now this sporophyte, now this is gametophyte. The sporophyte is parasitic on gametophyte. The gametophyte is free living, green, photosynthetic. This is parasitic, non-green, non-photosynthetic. It is divided into foot, it is CT, capsule. Within the capsule is formed, you know, this sporangia. This capsule ke andar the cell will undergo meiosis to form haploid spores. The spore will fall and it will form gametophyte. The first gametophyte formed is filamentous. This is called as protonema. Then it divides and redivides to form this erect structure once again, and thus the gametophyte has been formed once again. Now you will see the main gametophyte is the most predominant part. Gametophyte throughout the life cycle paya jata hai. Aur sporophyte kuch der ke liye paya jata hai, par paya jata hai. Since the main plant body is gametophyte, which continues for a longer time, and sporophyte is also a part which stays but for a less time, so we call this cycle as haplodiplontic, because the gametophyte is haploid and the sporophyte is diploid. So the life cycle is called as haplodiplontic. This is the general strategy of their sexual reproduction, that which happens in bryophytes. Now, whatever, let us have a discussion on the reproduction in bryophytes. So let us look at this. In bryophyte, the asexual reproduction, the vegetative propagation takes place by fragmentation. Why? Bryophyte mein you saw that the protonema, I told you the protonema stage is filamentous. I showed you that, did I not? कि the protonema stage was filamentous, जो first stage आया था, and anything which is filamentous can reproduce by fragmentation. Then sexual reproduction involves multicellular, jacketed and 3dia. Look at this. This is the male part. This is multicellular, jacketed and 3dia. That is the male sex organ, and multicellular, jacketed female sex organ, also called as archegonia. The antheridia produces a number of biflagellated, you can see two flagella, biflagellated male gamete called as sperms or antherozoid. Jabki jo archegonia, it is flask shape. Ye sab bhi aata beta description. So you will read every point thoroughly. It is flask shape with a tubular neck. You can see the neck is tubular and a swollen base. Called as venter, जिसके अंदर female gamete, egg और oosphere, जिसके अंदर में आपका female gamete, also called as egg or oosphere, is actually found, right? So now the presence of water is required for swimming of the sea. Water is required for swimming of the male gamete into the female for fertilization, because since they still depend on water for transfer of gametes or reproduction, they are called as amphibians of the plant kingdom. Fertilization leads to formation of a diploid zygote inside the archegonia. This zygote will divide to form an embryo, and this embryo constitutes the sporophyte. See, I am telling you so many times. This sporophyte, now look at the diagram of this sporophyte. This is interesting. Look at the diagram of this sporophyte. The sporophyte remains attached to the gametophyte. It see, it remains attached. Look at this part. It remains attached to the gametophyte for support, shelter and nutrition. The capsule part, see the capsule, I've drawn another diagram for this capsule part. See, the capsule, look at this part, produces haploid spores through meiosis, and when these spores they fall down, they will again develop to form a gametophyte. The first stage of the gametophyte is filamentous, and this filamentous stage is called as protonema. Once this has been formed, this will develop, then it will divide to form a mature gametophyte. So this is about the reproduction in bryophytes. Now let us look at the economic importance. This also is important. Some mosses, they are used as food for herbaceous birds and animals. So many of the bryophytes are used as food. One species, also called as sphagnum, it is used as peat that has been long used as fuel. I don't know whether you know or not. मुझे पता नहीं आपको पता है कि नहीं. The coal that we use today, जो हम कोयला इस्तेमाल करते हैं as a fuel, this is actually the remains of plants which have been buried below the earth. प्लांट, बहुत सारे प्लांट नीचे दब के यू नो उनका कार्बन कंटेंट सॉलिडिफाई होकर कोल बनाया, तो विच प्लांट? इट इज टेरिडोफाइट्स. जो हम लोग कोल यूज करते हैं, दीज आर एक्चुअली फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम प्लांट्स. विच प्लांट? टेरिडोफाइट्स. जैसे कोल एक हाई लेवल का फ्यूल है, वैसे एक लो लेवल का फ्यूल होता है, पीट कहते हैं उसको, है ना. एंड दैट पीट इज एक्चुअली मेड फ्रॉम ब्रायोफाइट, नॉट टेरिडोफाइट. एंड विच स्पीशीज ऑफ टेरिडोफाइट? इट इज स्फैग्नम, विच इज यूज टू मेक पीट. दैट इज अ लो क्वालिटी फ्यूल. Now I also told you one thing about bryophyte, that they can absorb atmospheric moisture. As a result, because of their capacity to hold water, they are used as a packing material for transshipment material. जब हमको suppose if I need to you know, I told you earlier also कि अगर हमको flowers भेजना है, say Ranchi से I want to send it to some other country. रांची में कोई फ्लावर बहुत अच्छा होता है, तो मुझे क्या लग रहा है रास्ते में वो पेरिश नहीं कर जाए. सो वी नॉर्मली रैप इट विद ब्रायोफाइट्स मॉसेस, बिकॉज बीइंग हाइग्रोस्कोपिक, हवा से नमी जो टालते हैं तो उससे वो अंदर की मटेरियल को मॉइस्ट रखते हैं. दैट इज व्हाई दे यूज फॉर ट्रांसशिपमेंट ऑफ लिविंग मटीरियल. लिविंग चीजों को ट्रांसशिपमेंट करने के लिए इनका इस्तेमाल किया जाता है. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दिस यू विल स्टडी इन क्लास 12 एज वेल. They help build up soil on rocks. Just look it here, with the help of lichens. जब कोई भी ऐसा land होता है which is uninhabited, any uninhabited land जहां पर पहले से कोई living organism नहीं रह रहा है, उस land में the first organism that comes to live on that land, you know, if this is a land and this is a rock, the first organism which colonizes that land and helps to convert that land into a fertile land, that is lichens and mosses. Lichens and mosses, they secrete a acidic thing. Lichen secretes lichenic acid. Similarly, mosses also secrete some chemicals. This helps to erode these rocks, and thus they break down these rocks and they create soil, and thus they help in colonizing any barren land. किसी भी बंजर जमीन पे जो पहला लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म रहने आता है वो lichens and mosses होता है. ठीक, दस दे प्ले एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन प्लांट सक्सेशन. सिंस दे फॉर्म डेंस मैट, यू कैन सी मॉसेस जिस जमीन में रहते हैं दे फॉर्म अ डेंस मैट, कंप्लीटली यू नो डेंस मैट ऑन दोज मटीरियल्स. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज, सपोज ये मेरा कोई जमीन है, इसमें मॉसेस ने एकदम डेंस मैट बना रखा है. यू नो दैट सॉइल बंजर यानी कि इनफर्टाइल कैसे होता है, बाय इरोजन ऑफ द टॉप सॉइल. मेरा एक लैंड है, इस लैंड में मैंने अभी कुछ क्रॉप्स उगाए, से राइस उगाया. नाउ नेक्स्ट प्लांट विच आई विल प्लांट ओवर हियर विल बी आफ्टर 3 months. सो इफ आई लीव दैट लैंड लाइक दिस, खाली छोड़ देंगे तो हवा चलेगी, हवा चलेगी तो टॉप मोस्ट सॉइल को क्या करेगी, उड़ा कर ले जाएगी. और आपको पता है अगर टॉप मोस्ट सॉइल आपका किसी भी जमीन का चला गया तो लैंड बिकम्स इनफर्टाइल, राइट. तो ऐसे बैरन लैंड, खाली लैंड जिनको हमने कुछ दिन के बाद यूज करना है इन एग्रीकल्चर, उसमें हम मॉसेस को उगा देते हैं. सी एंड दे एक्चुअली ग्रो लाइक अ मैट, एकदम मैट के जैसा वो नेचुरल कवर बना देता है उसके ऊपर. दस दे प्रिवेंट द इंपैक्ट ऑफ फॉलिंग रेन एंड प्रिवेंट सॉइल इरोजन. जो पानी और हवा जो चलती है, जो टॉप मोस्ट सॉइल को उड़ाकर ले जाती है, मॉसेस को उगा देने से वो एक मैट और कवर का काम करता है जो टॉप मोस्ट सॉइल को इरोड करने से रोकता है. सो दिस इज अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ब्रायोफाइट्स. नाउ दैट वी हैव लर्न दिस मच फर्स्ट वी विल सी इट इन द एनसीईआरटी. सो प्लीज लुक एट दिस पेज ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी. ब्रायोफाइट इंक्लूड्स बेसिकली टू टाइप्स, मॉसेस एंड लिवरवर्ट्स. I will be teaching you that later. Bryophytes are also called as amphibians of the plant kingdom. They are called as amphibians of the plant kingdom because this is a very very important question. आप यहाँ लिख सकते हैं, why are they called as amphibians of the plant kingdom? Because though they live in soil, but they are dependent on water for sexual reproduction. That is why they occur in damp, humid places. Now the plant body is little bit more developed than algae. It is thallus-like, prostrate or erect, and it is attached to the substratum by rhizoids. For medical, you will take note of all the descriptions. यहाँ क्या लिखा है? The rhizoid can be unicellular or multicellular. That means if this is your rhizoid, it can be multicellular, the root-like structure rhizoid, or it can be unicellular. You will take note of these small details. They lack true root, stem or leaf. They may possess root-like, leaf-like, stem-like structures. The main plant body is gametophyte. The sex organs in them are the antheridia, teeth which produce biflagellated antherozoids. The female is Archegonia, it is flash shaped, produces a single egg. The antherozoids are released into water, then they come in contact with Archegonium. It fuses to form zygote. Zygote divides to form a multicellular sporophyte. The sporophyte is not free living. I told you, if this is your gametophyte, right? So you know that the sporophyte is not free living. Rather, the sporophyte is attached to the photosynthetic gametophyte and it derives its nourishment from it. Some of the cells of the sporophyte, they undergo meiosis to produce haploid spores. These spores will fall down and they will develop into a new gametophyte, right? So this is about the main structure. Now let us come to the economic importance. So that paragraph actually dealt with the general structure of the body. Now we'll come to the economic importance. Now this is also very important. Some of them, they provide food. Now sphagnum is used to make peat. It is used as transshipment for living material. Along with lichens, they colonize rocks. Okay? Since they form dense mat, they prevent soil erosion. So this is about the economic importance. Now that we have done it, we will move back to our PowerPoint to understand more about these bryophytes. So now let us come to the... This is just showing some diagrams how this form acidic bonds. This is a sphagnum which makes peat, right, which is used as fuel. Now bryophyte classification. The bryophyte has been divided into further three subtypes. One is called as hepatophyta. The other is called as anthocerophyta. And the third is called as, you know, bryophyta or the mosses. Now listen. This hepatophyta includes liverworts and bryophyta, just calling them as the domain bryo, it includes mosses. This one is no longer in your syllabus. So just look at this. The hepatophytes are also called as liverworts. You must be knowing hepato also means liver, hepatic cells, liver cells. They are actually dichotomously branched like liver cells. You know, liver ki cell jaisa dichotomously, matlab do mein aise branched hai. So since it resembles a liver, so we call them as liverworts. These are called as hornworts because iska tips thoda sa hai, they are look like horns. And this one is your mosses. We are going to study only liverworts and mosses as in your syllabus. So first we will move into liverworts. Please have a good look at all the diagrams and try to understand it well. First, then I will tell you the difference between the two, liverworts and mosses. Please see this. As you can see here, the body is dorsoventrally flattened. That means, jo abhi maine aapko diagram dikhaya tha, jahan par body erect tha, that was of mosses. Liverwort ka body is like this. It is dorsoventrally flattened. It is appressed to the substratum. You can see it very well here. They are dichotomously branched. You can see that. It is quite flattened. And it is heavily, branched into two. Do mein ye branched hai. The thallus is dorsoventrally flattened, dichotomously branched and appressed to the substratum. Some liverworts have little leafy structures. Look at this. This is a liverwort. Ya ek central axis hai. Is central axis ke dono taraf, it appears to have little tiny leaf-like appendages on two rows on the stem-like structure. This is the stem-like structure and there's one row this side and there's one row this side. So though all liverworts are appressed, right, very close to the substratum, they are dichotomously branched. Some of them have tried to develop leafy structures like the porella. This is the diagram of porella. Okay, next we will come look at its thallus very closely. You can see it is quite enlarged and the thallus is very clearly visible. The thallus is dichotomously, see, it is branched in twos, branched, and here you can see some prominent depressions. These depressions are called as gemma cups, right? These depressions are called as gemma cups and these gemma cups are unique only to liverworts. I am not even saying bryophyte. ब्रायोफाइट में भी ये सिर्फ लिवर वर्ट में पाया जाता है, मॉसेस में नहीं पाया जाता। और इस गेमा कप का काम क्या है, इसमें स्मॉल लीफी स्ट्रक्चर्स कॉल्ड एज गेमा इज प्रेजेंट, राइट, इज प्रेजेंट। एंड दिस गेमा व्हेन इट डिटैचेस फ्रॉम द पेरेंट प्लांट इट डिवाइड्स टू फॉर्म अनदर वर्ट, लिवर वर्ट। सो इट हेल्प्स इन एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। वी विल हैव अ क्लोजर व्यू of this gamma, just see this, I have collected this specially for you, see, I am giving you a closer look, now this is your gamma cup, you can see this, and here the gamma cup, see this cup is enlarged, and you can see these small structures called as gamma, and when these gamma will detach, they will divide and redivide to form again a liverwort. So these are, so how does a liverwort look, it looks like a liver, it is flattened, dichotomously branched, greeny in structure, it has depressions called as gamma cup, which contains special asexual structures called as gamma, and this gamma basically helps in asexual reproduction. Now, where does sexual reproduction take place in liverwort? So have a closer look. ये जो liverwort आपका है यहाँ पर, I will explain you everything. देखो ये ऐसा dichotomously branched है, लेकिन इसी liverwort में, see they are all close to the substratum. You have certain, this is that apparent structure. Isme, you can see here, there is a long stalk-like structure. You can see here, some of this long stalk-like structure. On this, the male gametangia, that is the anthridia and archegonia are formed. Maybe, agar sexually, ye plant to gametophyte hai. Gametophyte hai, to kya banayega? Gamete banayega. To gamete kis pe banayega? एंथ्रीडिया आर्किगोनिया में, तो एंथ्रीडिया आर्किगोनिया कहाँ है, तो ये बॉडी जो चपटा है इसमें नहीं है एंथ्रीडिया आर्किगोनिया, इसमें ऐसे स्टॉक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर पाए जाते हैं, एंड हियर द एंथ्रीडिया आर्किगोनिया फॉर्म ऑन दिस फ्लैटेंड स्ट्रक्चर्स, राइट। द स्टॉक व्हिच बेयर्स एंथ्रीडिया इज कॉल्ड एज एंथ्रीडियोफोर, इज कॉल्ड एज एंथ्रीडियोफोर, एंड दैट स्टॉक व्हिच बेयर्स The archegonia is called as archegoniophore, right? This is called as archegoniophore. Now let us have a closer look of this anthridia and archegonia. चलिए इसका closer look लेते हैं. So this is the diagram from your NCERT, and trust me, this is a very, very, very important diagram. This also comes for your labeling, right? So let me just do it here. थोड़ा सा बड़ा कर दें, एंड यू कैन सी दिस, इट ऑल्सो कम्स फॉर योर लेबलिंग, इट कम्स फॉर योर मेडिकल एग्जाम। नाउ इफ यू लुक दिस, सी हियर यू हैव राइजोइड्स, दिस इज योर गेमा कप, ऑन दैट यू हैव अ स्टॉक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एंथ्रीडियोफोर, एंड दिस विल बेयर द मेल गैमेटेंजिया, दैट इज एंथ्रीडिया। लुक एट अनदर डायग्राम ओवर हियर, इस साइड में देखो एक और डायग्राम, अगर आप इस डायग्राम को देखोगे तो इसको एनलार्ज कर रहा है, ओनली दिस मच हैज बीन एनलार्ज्ड हियर। सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज योर स्ट्रक्चर, जिसके अंदर यहां पर, जिसके अंदर लाइक दिस वी हैव द एंथ्रीडिया, सी लुक एट दिस, दिस इज एन एंथ्रीडिया, दिस इज एन एंथ्रीडिया, दिस इज एन एंथ्रीडिया, जिसके अंदर मेल गैमेट एंथ्रोजोइड्स यानी कि स्पर्म्स आपके बनेंगे, राइट। सो नाउ लेट अस हैव अ स्टिल क्लोजर लुक ऑफ दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स। The anthridiophore bears anthridia. Look at this again, a closer look. This is anthridiophore. This under me, this is like this, and this is one anthridia. ठीक है, ये ऐसा structure है, इसके अंदर ये एक anthridia है. I'm just showing you some diagrams to explain things. Now let us come to the female part. I told you the stalk over here is called as archegoniophore. You can see that, and here also you can see. This is your gamma cup. Now this stalk is called as archegoniophore, and these individual leaf like structures that you see there, these are the archegonia. ये वाला, these individual ones, they are your archegonias. Just see an enlarged view. I'm showing you how the archegonia, it has a neck, then a swollen base called as venter, within which one female gamete or the egg is produced. You can see it very clearly over here. So this is your archegonia. So the stalk is archegoniophore, this individual is archegonia, and within the archegonia you can see this. Now what will happen is, the male gamete will swim up over here. It will, and the fertilization will be internal. Internal fertilization ke baad, this will form zygote. Right? Now, what I am talking right now is about liverwort and not mosses. Maine to jo diagram dikhaya tha, wo mosses ka tha. Now, this will divide. So, just see. This is this archegonia ka this part. And iske andar the zygote divides to form a multicellular sporophyte. This is your sporophyte. And this sporophyte ka this part is foot. This part is CT. And this part is capsule. In liverwort, the foot, CT and capsule are not as developed as in mosses. मैंने जो आपको पहला वाला डायग्राम पढ़ाया था वो किसका था? वो मॉसेस का था. मैंने जो पिछला वाला पढ़ाया, अभी क्या पढ़ा रहे? लिवरवर्ट. लिवरवर्ट में देखिए ये क्या है? आर्किगोनिया. इसके अंदर ये क्या है? सिंगल. इसके अंदर एग. दिस फर्टिलाइज करके क्या बना रहा है? जाइगोट. एंड द जाइगोट डिवाइड्स टू फॉर्म व्हाट? अ स्पोरोफाइट. दिस इज डिस्टिंग्विश्ड इनटू फुट, सीटी एंड कैप्सूल. वी विल सी मोर डायग्राम्स टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. द स्पोरोफाइट के अंदर स्पोर बनता है. अगेन द स्पोरोफाइट इज अटैच्ड टू द गैमेटोफाइट. It is nourished by it. By meiosis, it forms spores, and these spores will be dispersed by wind, and from there new, liverwort will arise. Now look at this diagram. This diagram will further help you understand the content. See, this is your archegoniophore. This is your archegonia. This is anthridiophore. This is the anthridia. The anthridia forms the male gamete, which are biflagellated anthrozoids or sperm. Within this, we find the female gamete, single, oogonia or egg. Water say the male will reach here. Fertilization will be internal. Now this, I have drawn it like this. ठीक है, इसको उलट दिया यहाँ पर. This is, after fertilization, this zygote will divide to form a sporophyte. See, this is the sporophyte. इसमें ऐसा sporophyte बनता है, छोटा सा. Unlike mosses, जहां स्पोरोफाइट इज वेरी डिस्टिंक्ट इनटू लाइक दिस फुट, सीटी, कैप्स्यूल. यू रिमेंबर इन मॉसेस इट लुक लाइक दिस, बट इन लिवरवर्ट इट डेवलप्स फ्रॉम दिस जायगोट, इट विल डेवलप लाइक दिस. ठीक है, दिस इज फुट, सीटी एंड कैप्स्यूल. यू कैन सी दिस. सो दिस इज योर सीटी. नाउ दिस इज फुट एंड दिस इज कैप्स्यूल. विद इन द कैप्स्यूल बाय मियोसिस यू विल हैव स्पोर्स. इट विल रप्चर, द स्पोर्स विल फॉल. They will form and they will germinate to form another gametophyte. That means another liverwort. So this is how they complete the life cycle. These elaters, they are hygroscopic. It is saying it is hygroscopic. ठीक है, it absorbs moisture, it breaks, the spores are released, and within at a rate of few at a time. And these spores, once they fall, they will germinate to form a new gametophyte. So this is about your liverworts. So I am sure अब आपको liverwort का structure पूरा अच्छे समझ में आ गया. This is another diagram showing the complete life cycle. We can see this once again. So this is a liverwort. You can see it is appressed to the substratum. It is dichotomously branched. ठीक है, then here it is, you have root like rhizoids. Then this is your archegoniophore. This is your anthridiophore, one of them. ठीक है, so this is your maybe anthridiophore. In archegoniophore you have archegonia. Within the archegonia you have the egg. In anthridiophore you have the male gamete. Where it is showing? Oh, it's showing here. This is your anthridiophore. Within the anthridiophore you have anthridia, which forms the male gamete. Male female gamete will fuse to form zygote. This zygote will divide to form a sporophyte. This zygote will divide to form a sporophyte, which is divided into foot, CT and capsule. This will form spores. The spore will form and they will germinate once back again into a gametophyte. So this is how they reproduce. So this is all about your liverworts. Once we have completed liverworts, now we will move into mosses. So how are liverworts and mosses different? You know that liverworts are flattened, appressed to the substratum. Only the reproductive parts are erect on stalk-like structures called as anthridiophore and archegoniophore. Reverse to this, ठीक इसके विपरीत, mosses का body कैसा होता है? It is little erect. The gametophyte is little leafy. It has root-like, leaf-like and stem-like structures. So this much is already known to you. So let us now move into mosses. You can see some mosses over here. It's written mosses, they resemble miniature vascular part. प्लांट्स, ये थोड़े बहुत मिनिएचर प्लांट जैसे लगते हैं, दो दे डू नॉट हैव वैस्कुलर बंडल्स राइट, बट दे रिजेंबल लिटिल बिट लाइक टेरिडोफाइट्स और अदर प्लांट्स बिकॉज द मॉसेस हैव बिकम इरेक्ट लाइक अदर प्लांट्स. दे हैव स्टेम एंड लीफ बट देयर स्टेम एंड लीफ आर नॉट ट्रू stem and true leaf. Why? Because they do not bear vascular bundle, they do not bear veins and veinlets. Here, first gametophyte, the first gametophyte that comes, it is filamentous and this is called as protonema. Now, from this protonema, you can see initially there is a lot of protonema being formed over here. From these protonema, then a lateral branch arises and then they become leafy in structure and they become the moss with which you are familiar with. Right, first is the filamentous protonema and these protonema then divide to form the erect structure with which you are acquainted in. Here you can find stem like colloid and then you can find leaf like phylloid is actually found in the mosses. So now let us move. We have already studied the life cycle of mosses, right? So let us quickly see it once again. You know that the gametophyte is the dominant phase. Right, gametangia are multicellular. You can see here the it has so many cells. So the gametangia is multicellular. You can see non-jacketed. See, unlike algae, which was unicellular and non-jacketed, it is jacketed. I'm just showing you in part. The Anthidia produces numerous biflagellated sperms. Archegonia produces a single egg. Fertilization is internal. You can see that. The fertilization is internal, ठीक है? And after fertilization, it forms a zygote. This zygote will divide to form a multicellular structure called as sporophyte. The sporophyte, as you know, is divided. It is attached to the gametophyte, derives its nutrition from here. This zygote will divide to form a diploid sporophyte. This remains attached to the gametophyte with the help of foot. ठीक? When it gets mature, it gets differentiated to form a CT and later it forms a sporangia within the capsule. So this is foot, this is CT, this is capsule. The capsule bears the sporangia. Within the sporangia, the spores will be formed. ठीक है? They will be dispersed by wind and then they will germinate to form a gametophyte. We have already done it numerous times. You have already seen this, the capsule, how it releases. We have seen this diagram once again. So last time let us see it. This is the multicellular gametophyte. It has root-like rhizoid, stem-like colloid, phylloid. Here is the archegonia. It is flask-shaped. You know, then it will have swollen base called venter, a single non-motile egg. This is your anthidia. It has many biflagellated male gamete. It will go by water. Fertilization will be internal. After fertilization, it will form zygote. The zygote will divide to form sporophyte. The sporophyte remains attached to the foot. Then CT and capsule. The capsule produces spores. The spores, they fall down. And the first moss that is formed, that is actually filamentous. This is called as protonema. ये बहुत बार आएगा. Protonema बनना, ये actually पहले कौन आया था? पहले तो pteridophyte आया था, बाद में moss आया था. तो ये proto, आपको पता है liverwort पहले कौन आया? Pteridophyte बोल रहे, पहले कौन आया था? Liverwort, बाद में आया moss. Liverwort ऐसा है, moss ऐसा है. तो first stage of moss being like this, it shows that its ancestors were like this. Since liverwort was like this, moss became like this. The first stage of moss is still like this, showing that my ancestors were like this because liverworts were like this. So this is somehow showing its resemblance with liverwort who were flattened to the substratum. Till later it becomes erect to form this complete gametophyte. So this is about its life cycle. So once this has been done, we will go for some important examples. Liverwort का दो आपके बुक में एक ही एग्जाम्पल है, दैट इज रिक्शिया. बट आई एम गिविंग यू टू, वन इज रिक्शिया एंड मार्केशिया. रिक्शिया इज सॉरी इन योर एनसीईआरटी देयर इज ओनली वन एग्जाम्पल, दैट इज मार्केशिया. राइट, इन योर एनसीईआरटी लिवरवर्ट का ओनली वन एग्जाम्पल, दैट इज मार्केशिया. आई एम गिविंग यू अनदर रिक्शिया. यू विल नॉट बिलीव, रिक्शिया कम्स इन मेडिकल लाइक एनीथिंग, बहुत आता है. I'll tell you what is a major difference between rickshaw and markhansia. Both of them, they look alike. The major difference is that in rickshaw, now look at this, in rickshaw, both the anthridia and archegonia, they are found on the same plant. That is, the plant is bisexual, which is also called as homothalamic. Homo means same, thalamus, thalus. So since on the same thalus, both the male and female parts, that is Antheridia and Archegonia, is formed, so we call it as homothalamic. So Riksha is that. Jabki Markinshya is heterothalamic. That means the male is found on different and the female is found on different. So this is the diagram of Markinshya and this is the diagram of Riksha. I'm sorry, the diagrams mein thoda confusion ho gaya. Let me show you. So these two are the diagram of Markinshya, which is in your NCRT, and this is Riksha. Your NCRT does not have Riksha, so I have drawn it. So this is Riksha and this is Markinshya. In Markinshya, the Antheridiophore and Archegoniophore are found on two different plants. As a result, they are unisexual and they are bisexual. This is the main difference between the two. In mosses, three important examples you have to know along with their diagram. This is Fumaria. The most common one which I have been teaching you throughout, this is your Fumaria. This is your Polytrichum. Right, and this is sphagnum, jisse aapka low quality, you know, coal, that is peat aapka banta hai. Theek, so with that, your bryophyte is complete. I will just quickly give you a contrast between the mosses and the liverworts. You will see that, as I told you, bryophytes are the second category of plants after algae. The body is not very much differentiated into root, stem and leaf. It is still the primitive type. So we call such a body as thallus. In liverwort, the thallus is like this, apris to the substratum, right? It is dichotomously branched. You can see they have typical gamma cups, and the male and female gametes, they are born on stalk-like structures called as Antheridiophore and Archegoniophore. In contrast to that, the mosses, from like the liverworts were like this, so mosses have become like this. Their body has gone erect. You can see, so this part is your gametophyte, right? And from gametophyte, you can see the sporophyte arises, and this sporophyte is actually parasite on the gametophyte. It is the non-photosynthetic parasitic, and this is photosynthetic green and free living. And this, they will then form spores, which will fall down to form new liverworts, right? So with that, we have completed bryophytes. And what we have completed, you know that, we will see it in the NCRT once. So come from here, NCRT. In liverworts, they grow in moist, shady habitat. The plant body is thalloid. One example is Markinshya. I insist, please add Riksha over here. I insist. Riksha is more primitive and Markinshya is more advanced type of liverwort. And it's a lot. When papers solve, you will see it. The thallus is dorsoventrally closely apressed to the substratum. Some leafy members have leaves along a margin in two rows. I showed you in Porilla. Asexual reproduction takes place by fragmentation, also by gemma. Gemma is what? It is a multicellular asexual bud which develops in a receptacle called as gemma cup. This gemma becomes detached from the parent and they germinate to form new individuals. Now we will come to the sexual reproduction. The male and female organs are produced on either the same or different thalli. Theek hai? In same, I gave you, the male and female will develop on same in whom? In Riksha. And they will develop on two different on whom? In Markinshya. Beta, ye sab khub aata hai medical mein. Isliye isko itna zyada repeat kar rahe. The sporophyte in case of liverwort and mosses is differentiated into foot, CT and capsule. With meiosis is formed within the capsule and the spores, they germinate to form a free living gametophyte. Now let us come to mosses. In mosses, the main life the stage of the life cycle is a gametophyte, and you know that in mosses the gametophyte is in two stage. One is the protonema. The first gametophyte is filamentous, right? It is filamentous. The first gametophyte, which is formed from the spore, it is actually filamentous, and this is called as protonema. Very, very, very important question for school exams. Protonema. Theek? This the second stage, iske upar develop karta hai. That's the leafy stage. Theek? It develops from a lateral bud. They are attached to soil through rhizoids, which can be through multicellular and branched rhizoid. That means unicellular rhizoids are formed in liverworts. आपने शुरू में पढ़ा था ना, राइजोइड कैन बी यूनिसेलर और मल्टीसेलर. द स्टेज बेयर सेक्स ऑर्गन्स एट दिस स्टेज. ठीक, एंड विद इन दैट द एंटायर वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन अकर्स बाय फ्रैगमेंटेशन एंड बडिंग इन द सेकेंडरी प्रोटोनिमा. इसका भी बड बनता है जिससे आपका नया बन सकता है. सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन में एंथीडिया एंड आर्किगोनिया, यू नो दैट दे आर प्रोड्यूस्ड एट द टिप ऑफ द लीफी शूट्स. After fertilization, the zygote will develop into sporophyte, which consists of foot, CT and capsule. Okay, the sporophyte in mosses is more elaborate. You can see it's more prominent, tall than the liverwort. The capsule contains spores. These spores are formed by meiosis. Okay, they have an elaborate mechanism for dispersal of spores. स्पोर विंड से उसमें एक इलेटर होता है जो ऐसे बर्स्ट करता है, जस्ट लाइक द वे यू बर्स्ट दोज, यू नो, बर्थडे पार्टीज में यू बर्स्ट दोज, जिससे वो आपका ऑल दोज ग्लिटर्स एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स दे कम. तो सिमिलरली इट जस्ट बर्स्ट एंड इट कम्स आउट. दे हैव एलैबोरेट. सम कॉमन एग्जांपल्स आर फ्यूनेरिया, पॉलीट्राइकम एंड स्फैग्नम. सो विद दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द सेकंड टाइप ऑफ प्लांट, दैट इज ब्रायोफाइट. वी डिड इट वेरी इलैबोरेटली. आई वाज वेरी स्लो व्हाइल टीचिंग एंड आई शोड यू एवरी डायग्राम वेरी क्लियरली. आई होप ब्रायोफाइट्स इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू. बट स्टिल एज आई ऑलवेज से, प्लीज गो थ्रू द वीडियो वंस अगेन. ट्राई टू फिगर आउट एवरी डिटेल्स ऑफ द फिगर. ट्राई टू लर्न एवरीथिंग गिवन इन योर एनसीईआरटी. दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. And it holds a lot of questions in the board exam, medical exam. In school all exam also it all comes, but it depends on the teacher. So with that advice, I sign off today with that same request as I put it every day, that please, you know, write it at the bottom as to how you like this lecture by showing that pressing that, you know, like button or putting your comments. And if you are new, please subscribe. Please visit our lecture again. In the next lecture, I'll be taking up pteridophytes. Till then, be safe, be happy, and I wish you all the luck and